Hi. Amen, that she forgives us. Be praised, God. I've been getting here and not here. They just are coming through here, they keep coming, and you are not changed. They just come through, we bury the dead.
That's it.
We bury, put them away. And then you sit it for a minute, and you get up, do the same thing as hell. He said, he's tired, he said, set your affection on him, and not seeing the need. Now, we didn't expect Mary to go at that time. And he said, that's the way I would come. Just like that. You think you have time, you come, you do your thing on weekends, weekdays, on weekdays. And then you come on in here, give him a praise. But he's tired. You say, God is a loving God. Yes, he is. God is forgiving God. Yes, he is. But you want him to forgive you and you get up and change. You don't want him to get down here and then he forgive you and then you get up and do the same thing. You want to change. When you say, Lord, forgive me, or when you tell your anybody, you say, forgive me, you want them to forgive you. And you're not going to do that again. You know? So like I said, it's sudden. We don't think. The one we think going to go, that's not the one. It comes sudden.
Yes,
it comes sudden.
Yes.
So when you make a change, like today, you done rejoiced and you love the Lord and this man in this building. Mm. But when you get out of this building, you got to love the Lord the same way.
Right.
You got to obey him. This is from the teenagers on up. The little sneaky things you do, he see you. He see you. Mama might not see you. Daddy don't see you. Pastor don't see you. And then y'all keep coming here, hearing the word over and over and over again. This is sound doctrine. It's supposed to be so. It's supposed to change. But you got to be willing to change. You got to be willing to change. Now all this partying and stuff y'all doing, it's over. Y'all got to, somebody got to stand up and say something. Like I said, it only takes one. It only takes one. If you got a friend that's not doing something, you stand up for what's right.
Right. Yeah.
Don't bow down to the devil anymore.
Yeah.
And you're going to be with a minister right because you know the way.
Yeah.
And you don't do what you're supposed to do.
Man.
So like I say, we bury them. We don't expect him to go. But that's the way God is going to come.
That's right.
Unexpected.
Yeah.
Life is like a vapor. It's unexpected. Come on, people. Let's change. Let's bring in change. Let's take this year. Let's go out and celebrate with a bang. Let's change. In 2016, we've been preaching Jesus on his way back, Jesus on his way back, Jesus on his way back. He on his way back. But he's trying to give you a chance to get right. If you don't get it right, it's on you. And I don't want to live bad down here and then have to go to hell.
Mm.
You don't want to have to do that. So let's stop burying them and then don't change. Let's change, people. Let's change. We always been the example church of what holiness is supposed to be like. Word deliverance is the example of what holiness is supposed to be like. So we're going to shake off everything that we've been doing. And we're going to change. Because I want to see Jesus. And I want you to see Jesus. I don't want to see him by myself.
We're
going to go out together. And if you know somebody that's doing something wrong, and you they friend, in this body, I ain't coming out there. In this back. Say, girl, that ain't right. And then get away from them. If they not willing to change, get away from them. Because you going to go down to them. And I've always been wanting to do something by myself. If I'm going to get in trouble, I'm going to get in trouble by myself. I ain't going to try to take nobody else to get in trouble with me. So let's get it right. So we can go home.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God, my God. Amen. Some of y'all probably don't know my wife, amen, but I would just love her.
Amen.
That's my first lady, 3210 Dragon. Now, who else do you know? Y'all got that?
Man.
Did you get the scripture? Yeah.
Lady.
1 and 7. Amen. That did with that first prayer. Amen. But as I was reading this, amen, there's three parts in here. Amen. When you're reading, you can't go too fast, amen, because there's a comma, and a comma. So there's three parts right there, y'all. And the first part says, the Lord is good. I can stay right there all day. The Lord is good. Oh, I just feel the goosebumps coming out of me. The Lord is good. Huh? Brother Tim, would you, Brother Tim, can you give me a shout out back there on that? Can you read that for me, Brother Tim? The Lord is good.
Yes.
And it says, the second part, a stronghold in the day of trouble. Giving you protection in all times of trouble.
Yes.
No matter where you at, what you going through, how does what it look like, but the Lord is good. You might don't think he is because you don't have that certain item that you want. You don't have that certain car that you want. You don't have them certain shoes or the dress or the home, amen. But I can tell you one thing. The Lord is good.
Yes.
Who woke you up this morning? Nobody but the Lord. The Lord is good. Who started you on your way? The Lord is good. Who else do you know? Who else do you know? And they say, and he knoweth them that trust in him.
All right.
He knows them that trust him. Amen. It's so ironic, amen. You can't put a fast one on God.
No, you cannot.
Because he ain't gonna go for it. He know when you with him. He know when you ain't with him. He know when you in the will. He know when you out of the will.
Yeah.
He know when you backslid. Amen. He know when you did wrong. He know when you shucking and jive. He know all that because the Lord is good. And I thought about that, amen. That, you know, when you was in school, amen, the teacher was doing the homework on the board and you didn't know what was going on, amen. Somebody might just want to raise their hand up real fast, amen. Amen. Somebody out there might want to raise their hand up real fast. Say, look, Mr. Walters, the Lord is good. Can I tell you how good he is?
Yes, yes.
One thing he does, amen, he supplies all your needs. That's one good thing that he does. He said, I'm going to supply all your needs. Can I tell you how good he is? He said, I'm going to make a way out of no way. Not only am I going to supply your needs, I'm going to make a way out of no way. Amen. How many know that, man, one day you reached in your pocket and you know you didn't have that $50 bill, and you reached in that and it was a $50. Anybody get that? Amen. Reach to that. No, you knew that money wasn't there. But God said, I'm going to plant something right there. Who else do you know that is good? Can somebody tell me, who else do you know that's good? Anybody know another good person? Anybody know another a good man who paid the price for us? Amen. Who got whipped, got beat up? Do anybody know anybody else who sacrificed his life for us? But the Lord is good. Just think about it, amen, amen. You supposed to be gone a long time ago. But God let you come in one more day. He said, I'm going to make this day your day. I'm going to do this for you on this day. I'm going to wake you up. I'm going to blow on your nostrils. I'm going to touch you. I'm going to shake you. He didn't have to do that. But that's how good he is, Pastor. But who else do you know? He knoweth them that trust him. Whatever I got, it belongs to God. because I'm just here on borrowed time. That home of me, that's God's home. That car driving, that's God's car. The shoes I got on them, these God's shoes. I'm just here on borrowed time. I just come to pay some rent on this morning. I got to give the man what he wants. Because the Lord is good. And another thing, how good he said, I'll make your enemies your footstool. Yes, hey man, you know, man, it's so good you can just sit back in the chair and just put your foot up and know that no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. But the Lord is good. If you don't know he's good, hey man, look over there to my left, to your right. And there's Mrs. Sanders over there.
Man.
Now she was carrying it, but amen, God's gonna make a way that she ain't even gonna have that no more. That's how good he is. I wanna know if I have anybody who can testify on that. I wanna know if I have anybody who can stand up and say, I know that God is gonna do it because I'm waiting and I'm waiting patiently on the Lord. Ooh, glory to God. Who else? Do you know? Cast all your cares upon him. For he cares.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. God got so many burdens, amen, on this morning. God got so many cares this morning, amen. Amen. And still got room for you.
Yeah, yeah.
Still got some room for you. Amen. His arms are so wide. He sits high, amen. He's looking over everything. But that's how good God is.
Yes, he is.
Who else? Do you know?
Yes.
That is good. But God, you might be good cooking barbecue. But God is good bringing you out.
Yes.
Look across, you might be good cooking them pies.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But God is good at sweetening them up.
Yes, yes.
That's how good he is. Sister Minifer, you might be good making them peach cobbler. But God is so good, he can put the finishing touch on things. That's how good God is. Who else do you know? Amen. He said, I can change the impossible into possible. And some of y'all said, no, that boy ain't gonna be saved. No, that boy ain't gonna, he ain't gonna be right. No, that boy, he always gonna be a thug. No, look who's at the urchin boy now.
Mm-hmm.
Look who's urchin now. Amen. Look who's preaching now. Amen. I was messed up from the flow on up. Amen. I was just like a dirty dish rag. But look at me now. God can come in and clean you up. He can put in and put a new heart in you. Who else do you know that you can go to God any time of the day and give him a secret and it ain't going to get past that? God said, I got you. Don't worry about it. I got you. Who else do you know? The Lord is good. I heard somebody say all the time.
All the time.
I'm going to share a little testimony, amen. I'm going to show you how good God is. Amen. God has blessed me with old school. Some of y'all young people probably don't know what old school is. Amen. One of them old school back in the days, that's old school. Old car, the only man, one that's made out of hard metal. Not that fiberglass that somebody hit you and tore it out. Steel, that's what I'm talking about. Steel, old school. And amen. I've been told by a customer, I say, man, if anything happened, you put me in the wheel with that car. He said, well, it's going to be between you and my daughter. Well, I got the property. Just put me in the wheel on that car right there. Time went by, glory to God. Amen. Who else do you know but God is still good?
Yes,
amen. He came to me and said, well, my daughter don't want the car. You can have it.
My. Look at God.
Want to
do it?
You can have it. Yeah. Well, I ain't through yet. Oh. Somebody know that God is good.
Yeah,
amen.
Yeah.
Because the Bible says the Lord is good.
Yes, he is.
Glory to God. Amen. So, got the car. Amen. It's sitting in my garage. Amen. With a convertible top.
Thank God.
Old school. Brother Mike, I tell you, when I opened the trunk up, amen, it took me back to the old time, amen. It got a jacket now. Y'all young people don't know about that old school stuff. You get a jacket, stand up this high, and you put it up on your bumper, amen.
Yeah,
and you click on it and say, click.
Yeah.
Man, I said, look at here. Look how good you look about that old school, don't you?
Yeah.
Amen. T, I don't want to be son, amen. But amen, give me an old, amen. But anyway, he gave me a car.
I said,
I ain't got nobody right now, you know. You gotta let them know that. I ain't got nobody right now. I'm trying to sell something to get something. Amen. But the Lord is good. Glory to God. He said, I ain't even worried about that. He said, the car is yours. I ain't even worried about that. That's your car. I'd rather for you to have it than somebody else.